shot. Woohoo!
After more than a year without flying, it was about time to head towards another country by plane. And here we are in Sibiu Airport, and we are going to Ireland. Let the adventure begin. I haven't seen a plane in almost a year. I think it will be very crowded. For some reason, they gave me the 16 number, which is the emergency exit. And for that, I have extra leg room, which is pretty amazing. They have a window seat, and that's double amazing. A good start of the journey. The plane is not full. We have just landed in the beautiful city of Dublin. Apparently our flight had 1 hour delay, and we are the last ones on the plane. We took a boat from the airport to our hostel, and I think we arrived. We have just booked our stay here. We are sleeping in a 10 beds dormitory. We made our beds and we went outside for a walk.
And we just saw a guy who was riding his bike, and instead of the water bottle, he had on the on his bike a bottle of whiskey. What's the most Irish thing you've seen today?
Oh yeah, we were trying to find a place where we can have a beer, but yeah, everything is closed because it's 2 a.m. Apparently because the Irish people drink so much, you cannot buy alcohol after 10 p.m. which is understandable. Yeah, we ended up buying just water. So here is Ireland in his beauty. This hotel where we stay, it's right in the middle of the city, and we are close to pretty much everything. We are still looking for for food for the girls, because they are vegetarian. I'm waiting for the girls to buy the breakfast.
Vegan food!
Okay, so Lucy is booking our trip for tomorrow now.
And we are
continue to go in adventure.
At lunch, we had breakfast, and now we are heading towards Trinity College. Yeah, we wanted to visit the Trinity Library, but it's 18 euros, and we don't want to pay that much for a library. And we are heading to National Museum of something. We have just entered the National Museum of Ireland. We are about to arrive at St. Patrick Cathedral, and we are not sure what to do first, to have some beers or to enter the church.
Or to have some beers in the church.
Or both.
Yeah, combo. Yeah, we will have a cold one with the priest. So yeah, we decided to enter, but it's 8 euros and with 8 euros we can buy 2 beers, so priorities. Yeah, we are ready for our first beer here in Ireland.
Yeah.
A mighty Guinness.
Cheers.
Ca timpul de la intrare să fie, să fie român.
100%.
Foarte tare. Și am găsit localul ăsta care e mult mai mișto. E mult mai plin de oameni și de atmosferă. And it's amazing because right now the next band has arrived and we are right in front of them, and it's really amazing.
Series technology, etc. put money into it. Thanks very much.
Okay, so the party's over, we're going home, bye.
The party, it's over.
But we are not. We are ready to start another party.
Bitch, man, it was awesome. The best night ever.
We're all in this together. Yeah, we have to go home because we have to wake up at 6 to go on the trip. We have just woken up and we are ready for the adventure.
We're gonna bring us on board. Sure. So we are probably visiting Dublin for the first time. So that's Trinity College, of course, to your right there. Don't know if you've been inside yet. If you were, you possibly saw the book.
And here we are. We stopped in Belfast. We are currently here in a supermarket to buy some groceries and stuff for a few minutes. It's a break. And then we hop on a taxi tour around Belfast. It's prepaid by the company that we are with today. I'm having breakfast right now. It's something I bought yesterday from the Lidl. Yeah, after the taxi ride, we are going to Giant Causeway, which is right in the north of the Northern Ireland. We are in Belfast, and the tour guide is explaining us the history of Northern Ireland. And a rainbow has just appeared. Typically Irish. Yeah, this is the group that we are with. So the company that we went with, it's called the Wild Rover, and the plan was to visit the Titanic Museum, but it's closed today. And instead of that, we went with these taxis. It's called a political bus taxi or something like this. I don't remember. It was not that interesting because it was a lot of history and I'm not into history. But it's over and now we have several minutes left to buy something. And then we go to a Giant Causeway.
Opened
by
doors, you know?
The Titanic Museum.
That's what they decided to use for the time machine in
but
Back to the Future.
We can't visit it because it's closed. Castle. A smart idea to not bring the drone with me because we are not allowed to use the castle. Everything is so green due to the everyday rain. It's so windy. Yeah, this is the Atlantic Ocean.
So here we are at our last stop, our last food stop. as you can see, and then we are heading to Giant Castleway, I suppose, which is our last attraction for today. And afterwards, we'll go home to get a couple of Guinnesses as usual.
We have arrived at. Landmark of Ireland, the Giant Castaway, and one man is taking us are so lucky again to have such an amazing weather.
As always, wherever we are going, we have amazing weather.
Yeah. Because we are.
Yeah.
And the beauty of this place is just amazing. Astonishing.
Mesmerizing.
And here is the Atlantic Ocean and it's in its entire beauty. And down there are the giant gasaway.
Hexagonal columns. It runs 60 miles under the sea to the island of Staffa in Scotland. There are a few stones like it on the island of Staffa, but the majority are here. There is something similar in Iceland and there is something similar in New Zealand, but nowhere in the world is there the concentration of hexagonal stones here. They were formed 60 million years ago and the magma that came up was just the right viscosity or liquidity, the right temperature. It was forced out at the right speed and the outside air and sea temperature meant that it formed into perfect hexagons. If ever you've studied honeycomb, bees, nature loves hexagons. If you make things with circles, there's gaps in between the circles. So the hexagon is the strongest structure that nature can provide. Over there is Scotland. At the very edge, you can see the Mull of Kintyre. Those of you who are really old will know that Paul McCartney, when he left the Beatles, sang a song called the Mull of Kintyre. He lived there for many years with his second wife. That's about as much as I can tell you about the geology. The whole coastline is volcanic, the whole coastline is basalt, but only for 30 meters wide do you get the hexagonal blocks. We're going to walk another 5 minutes round to the next headland and there you can take a photograph looking straight down onto the causeway. It's one of the better photographs in Ireland. I'll do another little talk about the legends associated with the stones and then I'll shut up and then I'll take you back, okay? Over 100 years ago, Marconi came to Northern Ireland and he did the world's first radio transmission. Just round the corner to Rathlin Island, it's six miles off the coast. So it's far enough that people would believe that it wasn't a trick, that it wasn't some megaphone, it was a radio transmission. But it was close enough that he was confident that his equipment would work. So over 100 years ago, Northern Ireland was the first radio transmission. Today, half the people in Northern Ireland won't talk to the other half of the people. So times change.
The wind is blowing like crazy. Giant gasway and it's so amazing, the hexagonal shape, rocks. Woohoo! It's so beautiful. It's incredible how these rocks took the hexagonal shape. Atlantic Ocean! Woohoo! That's a big one! The GoPro ran out of battery and we arrived back at our hostel.
We decided to drink until our food is ready!
Yes.
Yeah, it's 9:30 PM. We need to finish this beer and then we head straight to the bar. Here we go again! Uh, we were not that lucky tonight with the seats. Yeah, yesterday we stayed right in front. Right now, we are just staying here. But we will move where the band is singing. The beer has just arrived. Check how much alcohol is here. Heaven.
Another day, another adventure. It's Thursday morning and we're going to the cliffs of Moher. Let's go.
An amazing start of the day. We came where we departed yesterday for the yesterday adventure, and there was no bus here, and so we went to the other stop and no bus was there either. We searched on the internet and we saw that it's here on the first place of departure, but on the other side of the street. A little jogging for to warm up the day. It's full of people, not like yesterday. Just a short stop on the road for a toilet break. We are about 1 hour and 45 minutes to the cliffs of Moher. This was just a 10 minutes break on the road. Stopped at the toilet. The Wild Rover tours are amazing. I think we'll have a great day today. And yeah, if you ever in Dublin and want to go somewhere, they can help you with the main attractions on the island, like the one that we went yesterday, the Giant Causeway, and today the Cliffs of Moher. I think it will be nice. We had an amazing sunrise, but right now it's cloudy, but hope the weather will get better when we arrive there, so we can see and yeah. We have arrived at the Cliffs of Moher. We can see the beauty of Cliffs of Moher right here. I'm standing right near the edge of the cliff. Dangerous! Incredible, so beautiful.
First takeover of the vlog for the day and hopefully the last.
Hopefully not the last.
Hopefully not the last. We are heading to our bus because our trip to the cliffs is over, almost over. Just take one more last look from the cliffs.
Be careful. Whoa.
The master itself. In his natural habitat. We were quite enjoying the weather not being so windy until it happened. It happened to all of us.
Our tour for the Cliffs of Moher is over and we are heading towards our bus. And from here we are going straight to Galway. But yeah, we visited the most beautiful landmark of Ireland.
Yes.
Yeah, in my opinion, yeah, the Giant's causeway was more beautiful than the Cliffs of Moher. But yeah, they were beautiful.
I am
definitely worth visiting both of them. let's hop and see you on the next destination. We stopped at a very nice rock formation. Our guide told us that this was formed on the last ice age around 10,000 years ago. It seems like we are walking on the moon. We have arrived in Galway and we are staying here 2 hours. We are on the streets of Galway, and the vibe here it's amazing. Yeah, so many people walking. It's so colorful. Lot of shops with different colors. Yeah, you can see that the Christmas is coming. It's full of decorations for Christmas. Yeah, we stopped here in Galway to have a late lunch or an early dinner, and we finally have the famous fish and chips of Ireland and some beers. Yeah, for some reason they don't have Guinness, but the Carlsberg works fine. Right, the food was amazing.
The best.
The fish was perfect, and the chips were very. The portions are very, very big. We took the regular one, and it was huge. We are back in Dublin. Yeah! We are back in Dublin, and it's pouring rain outside. We are going straight to our hostel and then to the bar, because it closes at 11:30, and right now it's 8 something, and we don't want to miss the show. We went to a different bar today, tonight, and the guy who is singing is amazing.
Weep for yourself.
Our stay here at Abigail's hostel it's over. It's a Friday and we are heading home today. We have the flight at 3 p.m. and right now it's around 10 a.m. Yeah, we're going to some museums and then straight to the airport. We have put a pin here on the map at the entrance of the hostel, and we are the only ones that put a pin from Romania. Maybe we are the first ones from Romania to come here. This is crazy. We are back at the airport. We spent the day just walking in the city and we visited the museum. We passed the security and now we are heading towards our gate, which is 106. We have barely made our flight. This is the plane we are taking. We are the last ones that arrived. Another day, another flight. We have just reached the cruising altitude and Irina came with the great idea of having some beers. We just approved because it's a good idea. So right now we are just waiting for the crew members to
jump on us.
I'm the first one leaving the plane. It's my first time leaving the first one. And here are the girls.
Yay! Yeah.
Yeah.